I'm Enrico from Italy.
Elena です。こんにちは。
Wow.
はじめまして。
We are in Italy. Are you from?
We are from Italy and be more detailed from Venice.
Venice is one of the biggest tourist places in the world.
Yes,
a lot of people go there for sightseeing.
It's full of tourists and we can't even walk on the city.
Yes, too busy, too crowded.
Yeah, you always have to be in the queue, like following the path of people and you can't run, you can't do anything.
Venice is like a lot of water.
It's like built by man on water, so they just placed a lot of trees under the water to hold up the city, and then they started to build all the small islands and connect the islands with bridges. And each island has a church,
and full of church.
In the end, it's all connected now. But
do you sometimes get on the boat to move to some places?
Yeah, we usually walk because it's more cheap.
Yeah, more cheap. For us, it's cheap as well on boat, but for tourists, really expensive.
If you're a tourist, it's super expensive. Vaporetto. Sometimes if you have to cross the river, like not the river but the canal, you can take a gondola, you know.
Oh, okay.
And it's quite cheap if you just have to cross that. If you want to do a tour with the gondola, it's super expensive, like 80 euro for half an hour, which is something like
1万円. How about this one? How much do you pay for?
Tourists pay 7 euro and you can even just do one stop with that.
Just one ride. You can take a daily pass bus, but it's like 35 euro, like 5,000 yen.
Yes.
With wasabi. This one has wasabi on top.
Oh, spicy.
You don't like spicy?
No.
Wasabi,
I can eat some wasabi because it's spicy, but only at the beginning.
Yeah,
yeah, red peppers, no, yes.
Yeah,
that's the point.
This one goes away, it goes up to the nose and stuff like that, but it doesn't last long.
Right. Why do you know some Japanese words?
It's our, actually it's our fourth time. Yonkai.
Yonkai?
Yonkai, in Japan.
Yes.
We are coming here every half, no, one year and a half, more or less. So it's useful to know some Japanese if you have to travel around.
And we like the culture, we like the people, we like the food, we like the country. So just we like it, so we like to know a bit more of it.
Hey, every time you learn something new here.
So this time you are in Tokyo and you go somewhere.
We actually arrived in Osaka.
Oh, you arrived in Osaka.
Is it Nagoya? Fujisan?
Fuji Highland. And then we came here.
But we already have been in Nara, in Nikko, Arashiyama. We would like to go to Okinawa, in the north.
Hokkaido.
Seaweed
maybe?
Yep.
Tonkatsu.
That's a lot. Did you know it was...
Okay, let's start. Itadakimasu.
Buon appetito.
Buon appetito.
Some fish on top, like red snapper.
Let's
see. First, we just mix it.
If it was for us, we didn't know. We were just eating some random stuff.
And in the end, we're gonna pour us some soup.
Okay, so it's not tea.
I think this is how to use chopsticks because it's kind of watery. You can use spoon.
Yes. Okay,
let's try. I think it's really light.
Yeah, that's right.
Really healthy. It's
not fried.
Like a risotto, a little bit.
Really?
Risotto, perfetto.
Yeah, it's nice because you can feel the different taste of everything. Even if it's together, you can. Is it just hot water?
It's a soup, like a broth.
Made of fish.
Made of fish.
Like a brodo.
Yes.
In Italian, we say brodo.
Yeah, go ahead.
Are you not going to take that?
I think the tonkotsu fried, deep fried, is one of my favorite food here.
Oh.
Yeah. It's after ramen.
It's very soft.
Yeah.
I don't know. Fresh. What's the name in Japanese?
Okay. Ebi fry.
Ebi. Yeah.
Shrimp.
That's very good. Is this tempura?
Or tempura is this.
Oh yeah, that is tempura. Yeah, yeah. You're right.
Because they use bread piece.
Bread crumbs.
Yeah. Roast beef, I think.
I think I will take some of this, maybe. Yeah, it's kind of sweet. Yeah, it's really good. The meat is really soft and...
So your channel, do you have many Japanese people or also some foreigners?
On a video, only foreigners.
Yes,
followers is 90% is Japanese.
So they want to know what we think about right? Japan.
Yes, mm-hmm. Japanese can know a bit more about the
foreign countries.
Yes.
Well, in Italy we have pizza, pasta.
You can't say
tortellini, lasagne.
You can't say what we have in Italy because it's too much.
Too much.
How about your region? Venice is what is the famous dish?
Bigo in salsa. Bigo in salsa.
It's one of the most famous. There's even some bigoi pasta, thick spaghetti like udon with a creamy sauce made of anchovies and onion. Polenta, you know polenta?
Polenta?
This is polenta.
Ah, polenta.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. It's a corn.
Usually eat that with some beef or
meat.
Like, you know, beef
chicken,
that has a lot of sauce.
Turkey.
Tomato sauce.
And we have pasta fagioli.
Pasta fagioli, yes, it's another kind of
pasta fagioli
dish from our region. Pasta
with beans.
It's a pasta soup made with a kind of beans soup. It's usually the typical dish of grandmas.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, my grandma always cook pasta fagioli. Yes.
Also,
Lizzie.
It's a risotto made with peas, the green peas, you know. It's kind of risotto with peas, like green peas. We've got typical salame from our region, which is it's a salame with garlic,
prosciutto
crudo,
yeah, full of fruits.
Really,
I can't remember.
So
mozzarella interrotto.
How about the cheese? Because there are so many types of cheese, right?
Yes.
Which one do you prefer?
Did you try Asiago cheese? Asiago cheese?
Yeah.
Wow, Asiago, no. It's not hard and it's not soft. It's kind of middle aged.
12 months.
Yeah, it depends. Kind of.
6 months. The older, the harder.
Oh, okay.
And the more expensive.
Yes. It's like Parmesan. Parmigiano.
Yeah, Parmigiano and mozzarella is like most common also
mozzarella.
For Japanese people.
I love mozzarella di bufala.
Bufala pizza is usually quite typical.
Yes. Here, right?
Yep.
It's soy sauce, I guess.
Yep,
Super fresh.
Super fresh.
Yeah.
Do you have to eat the skin as well?
Some people do not like the skin of the fish. I like it, but
I don't know what to say. Everything is good. I don't have complaints.
Yeah.
Oh, tempura. These are vegetables.
Fish.
Oh, fish.
Everything is really soft and fresh.
Yes. And do you know tiramisu? Tiramisu is from our region as well.
Oh, really?
Yes.
It should be from Treviso, which is like 20 kilometers from Venice. I don't know how to say that in English, like a protected city in the old ages. Like castles with walls around.
If I go to Venice, what is the specific places I should visit and see?
Well, Venice is not so big, so I think you should visit everything quite easily.
Yeah, I think 4 days in Venice are fine.
Mm-hmm. You can even just
walk around. That is what I suggest to do, because it's even nice to get lost inside a small street of Venice.
Yes.
But yeah, the main areas are San Marco Square and the Rialto Bridge, which is that famous bridge. Each part of Venice, it has something different and interesting, like some museum or some churches or something. And a lot of stuff are free, like the Basilica of San Marco, which is the main church of Venice. It's free to enter. So
wow!
It's in the main square of Venice. Yeah. Yeah, just get some.
Yes, take some tempura.
Okay, thank you.
Tabete kudasai.
Arigato.
Mm-hmm.
Now it became more like risotto. Even in Italy, it's not easy to find a good pizza sometimes. Because in the Venice city center, it's full of touristic places, not owned by Italian, but some Chinese sometimes. Other groups. So, and even if they are owned by Italian, it's not, they're not good.
In Venice is better to go to hidden places.
Not the main streets, maybe back streets.
Not those ones with the menu outside.
That's
not
touristic places. Not good food.
Not those ones with people outside asking you to come in. You should avoid those places.
Yeah, we found the ramen the other day.
We found a good
here
ramen
in Akihabara. And
do you know which one? I love ramen. It's I know a lot of ramen places.
Chisai places.
Jangara. Akihabara, you come here for because you like some anime or cartoons?
I like anime, but we came here for Nintendo Switch.
we love anime, but we even like to go around to amusement. How do you call that?
Taito Station, Sega.
Game Station.
Yes, we like Game Station.
In Italy, we don't have much. Yeah. But there's no UFO catcher like here. It's tricky. Tricky UFO catcher. You never
get it, yes.
And then we came here, just to find some retro gaming stuff. Because I love retro gaming consoles and
Game Boy.
I still need some PCs, so I just go around to search for them.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you. Everything was good. Oishi desu. Oishikatta.
Ciao.
Arrivederci.